Hey learner, this is Nilesh Borate. So in this video, we will continue the function exercise. Okay, so see here, my next question is that. So write a function that compute the volume of a sphere and pass the radius in parameter. Okay, calculate. Okay, see here, this is my function sphere. This is my radius. Okay. So my formula is that 4 by 3 into pi, so value of pi is that 3.142, okay, so this is my value of pi, then into radius raised to 3 means that the r cube, pi r cube, so raised to means that the double star, okay, so this is my formula. And here my sphere is that, sphere of 2 is that 33.5146. okay, so next question is that write a function that check whether a number is in the given range. So pass the three parameters to the function. First parameter is the number, second is your lowest number, and third is the highest number. So check whether this first number is in between this lowest and the highest number. Okay, def check range, number, lowest number, and this is the highest number. Okay, see here, check here if, okay, so if your number in range, there is a built-in function in the Python, range function. So low and high. So if you want the highest number, then pass here high plus 1. Means range is from lowest to highest. Okay. So if this is, then return number is in range. Okay, else return out of range. Okay, see here, check range. So my first number is that 10, starting is the 1 and the ending is the 100. See here, number is in the range. Okay, so if my number is 105, then see, out of range. Okay, next, write a Python function that accept a string and calculate the number of uppercase letter and lowercase letter. So count here. Okay, so see here, this is my function count letters. Okay, pass here the one string. This is my str. So first we assign the two variables, upper equal to 0 or the lower equal to 0. Okay, then this is your for loop. Okay, character in str. So one by one character in a string is going to char variable. Okay, and check here if char dot upper, if it is upper, then count the upper counter. Upper is equal to upper plus 1. Else count the lower count, lower counter. Lower is equal to lower plus 1. Okay, see here, count letters. So this is a string. See here, we not printing my answer here. So my answer is that after breaking this for loop, total upper is equal to and lower is equal to. So by using format function, pass the upper variable and the lower variable. Okay, so see here. Okay, upper function convert the character into uppercase. Here we need to check, is it upper? So function is upper. Okay. Okay, see here, now upper character is the 2 and lower equal to 14, so they count the space here. Okay, so here use the one condition L if char dot is lower. So here they only count the lowercase character. Okay, see here. So now my lowercase is the 11. Okay, so this is your program. So going to next, write a Python function that take a list and return a new list with the unique elements. Means you pass the one list which have the some repeated items and your output is that the unique elements. Okay, see here, def unique items, this is your list LST. Okay, see here, this is my empty list. Okay, x equal to, so by using for loop for item in LST, so one by one item is retrieving from the list and it is going to item variable. So see here, if item not in x, if it is not, then append item into x. Okay, and after breaking this loop here, return your x. See here, unique items. So here we pass the one list, 1 1 1 1 2 3 4 5 4 6 5. See, my output is that 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so not in, this is the opposite of in. So in, check if it is present in this list, then return true. Same, not in, if it is not present in this list, then it return true. Okay, so this is your empty list. So this one is the first item. Okay, so see here, one not in x, true, so it is appended to this x. Again one, so see here, previous one is already in a x, so next one not in x, false, so they not appended, going to next iteration. Okay, so by using this way we can remove the duplicate elements. Okay, so next program is that write a Python function to multiply all the numbers in a list. Means that if your list have the four numbers 1 2 3 4, then your output is that 1 into 2 2 into 3 3 into 4, means all the numbers in a list, they are multiplied with each other. Okay, so def multiply items. Okay, so this is your list, this is your answer, answer equal to 1. Okay, so for x in list, then answer is equal to answer into x. Okay, so after breaking this loop, you return your answer. So see here, my multiply items, this is a one list, 1 2 3 4. So see here, 1 into 2, 2, 2 into 3, 6, 6 into 4, 24. So my answer is that, the 24. Okay. Next, write a function to check whether a given string is palindrome or not. Okay. So my function name is that, the palindrome. This is your string. Okay. So see here. So palindrome means that your original string and the reverse string, if it is same, then return true. Okay, so see here, this is my, so first convert the string into reverse case. So see here, s equal to str of colon colon minus 1. Okay, so print here, this is your original string and this is your reverse string. So first we test this code, palindrome. So your string is that, the hello. So see here, so first str hello and this is s is the reverse. Okay, now here we check if your s is equal to str. If it is, then return palindrome string, otherwise else return not palindrome. Okay, So again we test this code. My answer is that not parent wrong. Okay. So my next string is that madam. So check, reverse of madam is that madam. So my answer is that palindrome string. Okay. So next, to check the given number is prime number or not. Okay. So check prime number. So def, my function name is that check prime. This is your number. Okay. So what is prime number? So prime number is that the number which is divisible by 1 and itself. Okay. So here we use the logic starting from 2. Okay. So here for x in, this is my range function starting from 2 number. Okay. Number means that range is from 2 to number minus 1. Okay. So check here, if your original number is that the number, so NO number mod x, if it is divisible, then here we set our the flag variable, flag equal to 1. So here my flag value is, default value is the 0. Okay. So see here, if your flag is equal to 0, means that this number is a prime number. Otherwise, print not prime. Okay, so see here, not prime. So this is the function. Okay, use some bracket here. Okay, so see, print. Okay, check here, check prime, number is that the 5. So 5 is the prime number because it is divisible by 1 and itself. 10 is not a prime because in between 1 to 10, 5 and 2, which are the divisor of 10. Okay, then 19 is a prime number. Okay, so students, test this code on your machine. So if you have any queries, then comment on your query in comment box. Like and subscribe the channel. See you on next video. Thank you.